Oh, hello! You must be the new recruits from the DuPage Children's Museum Tiny Great Performances. Well, let me be the first to welcome you to our office. This is a place where we can train our ears to become world-class musical detectives. My name is Parker, and it's my job to get your ears into shape so that you can solve some very tricky musical mysteries. Think you're up for the task? Great! Let's get started! Let's see, the first thing we need to do here is... introductions! Yes, let me introduce you to some of our agents in the field. First up is Grace, and Grace is going to tell us a little bit about the tools that she uses to solve her musical mysteries.
Hello to all of our musical detective trainees. My name is Grace. And I want to introduce you to an instrument that I use to make music. This is the oboe, and it is an instrument that uses air to work and is made of wood. For that reason, it is part of the woodwind family of instruments like the flute, clarinet, and bassoon. Can you say oboe with me? Oboe. In order to make a sound on the oboe, I have to blow air into this tiny little thing called a reed. A reed is two very small pieces of wood that are tied together. When I blow into the reed, the air makes the two pieces of wood bounce against one another very quickly, which we call vibration. The vibration makes sound. When I put that vibrating reed into the rest of the instrument, it makes a sound.
Thanks so much, Grace. Let me introduce you to our other agent in the field, Hareen, and she's going to tell you a little bit about her instrument.
Hi, everyone. My name is Hareen, and I play this instrument called the cello. Can you all say cello with me? Cello. Awesome job. The cello is a member of the string instrument family because it has these four strings that I use to create vibrations, which are what you hear when you hear sound. The cello is also very, very large. As you can see, there's actually a spike called an end pin that I use to anchor the cello on the floor so I can play it sitting down. Now, I can play the cello's four strings by plucking them. Or I can use this special tool called a bow. And when you look at the bow, there's a white section of actually hundreds of horse hairs that create the sound. Now, don't worry, the horse just gets a haircut. It doesn't get hurt at all. There are no horses injured in the process of making bows for string instruments to be played. But the bow horse set hair, when you play it on the string, sounds like this.
Thanks for being here, Grace and Hareen. Today, we have to start with telling our recruits a little bit more about opposites. I'm sure that you all are familiar with opposites. Opposites are things that are totally different or the complete reverse of one another. What are some opposites that you know? What about light and dark? Hot and cold?
Big
and small.
Those are all opposites, and today we're going to be exploring some musical opposites. But let's start by asking ourselves, which instrument is bigger? the cello or the oboe? That's right. The cello is big and the oboe is small. Let's take notes in our notepad because that clue might help us out later.
My instrument may be smaller than the cello, but its smaller size makes higher sound.
That's right, Grace. Sound travels into our ears through those vibrations that we talked about earlier. When we have small instruments like an oboe, it produces small vibrations, sometimes called sound waves. And when those sound waves go into our ears, they sound like high sounds.
Those high sounds make the oboe perfect for playing melodies. The melody is the main part of the music that is easy to sing along to.
Of course! Can we all say the word melody together? Melody! As Grace explained, melody is the main part of the music. If you have a favorite song, the part that you sing along to, that's the melody. Let's write the word melody down in our notebooks so we can remember it for later. Grace, do you think that you could play us a melody?
I can play melodies too, but because my instrument is so big and plays so low, the sound waves that are created are very, very large, and therefore to our ears they sound like very low sounds. Let me show you.
Ah, that makes a lot of sense. So smaller instruments make smaller vibrations that sound high, and bigger instruments make bigger vibrations that sound low, but they can both play the melody. Hey, I have an idea. With all of this talk of opposites and melodies, I think it's about time for your first test as musical detectives. Grace and Harine are going to play a piece of music for us. Now what I need you all to do is when you hear a high instrument like Grace's oboe, I want you to use your fingers to point up. And when you hear a low instrument playing the melody, like Harine's cello, I want you to point down. Don't worry if you get confused, I'll be here to help you along. Ready? Let's go! That was so much fun! Let's give Grace and Harine a big round of applause for helping us uncover the musical mystery of high and low instruments. And before we go today, let's review one more time all of the things that we learned by looking at our notepads. First, we learned about two instruments, the oboe and the cello, and the different ways that they can be played. The oboe is part of the woodwind family, and the cello is part of the string family. Next, we learned that the oboe is a small instrument that can make small vibrations and high sounds. The cello, on the other hand, is a bigger instrument that makes bigger vibrations and sounds lower. And last, we learned what a melody is and how to listen for melodies in the music we hear. Nice work, recruits! If you keep up work like this, you'll be world-class musical detectives in no time at all. Join us in our next video to learn about another important musical opposite. And until then, keep using those talented ears and stay curious. See you soon!